Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is Best and Slot, and we are back playing Jurassic World the game. And what are we doing with our lives? Well, first things first, all our dinosaurs have been fed and they're all hunky-dory, happy, happy, happy. We have a new creature, I believe. I mentioned the pyro. Oh, we have two, actually. They're both sitting ready to show you guys. We mentioned the pyroraptor in the last level. He's now finished and sitting there, but so is the tapajara, who is, I think we can all agree, pretty bloody terrifying, aren't you? Not a fan of your work, Tapajara. So that's our Tapajara. And over here, I think you guys are really going to like the Pyroraptor. Because he's got feathers. And it's very clearly feathers on the Pyroraptor. People said the Utah Raptor has feathers. The Utah Raptor kind of just looks fluffy to me. The Pyroraptor has very clear feathers. The arms and everything and... it's more like downy stuff, but still, it's very, very cool. Big fan of the Pyroraptor. Over here in our DNA thingamajiggy, on the way we have the Coolosuchus, which we unlocked last episode, and we are still 12 hours away from the Sukumite. We're going to go ahead and speed up the Coolosuchus. I don't care. Okay, let's get him out there. You're adorable. He looks like a puppy. A terrifying puppy, but still a puppy. Unfortunately, all these new creatures have kind of ruined my plan for the park in terms of style. I like you, Coolosuchus. Big fan of your work. I am curious as to whether a level 10 Coolosuchus is better than level 20 Limoncello. So 126 to 40 versus... 123 to 31. Yes, so Coolosuchus is now going to be our lead amphibious creature. And I believe Tapajara won't be, just because Tropy is level 30. A level 20 Tapajara would be better than a level 30 Tropy, but that's not the situation we're in. Now, a few of you have mentioned, rather intelligently, that... As you can see, I've connected this to my Facebook. Now, unfortunately, I connected it to the wrong Facebook account, so it's connected to my personal account, which means I won't be able to kind of like add everyone and do all that kind of jazz with this playthrough. Unfortunately, but hopefully that's not too big of a deal, because I don't know how to disconnect. I don't want to disconnect it in case I break something. Anyways, the point made was if you go and play Jurassic Park Builder on an Android device, and you attach it to your Facebook, and then you go play the game on Facebook with the same Facebook account you used on your Android device, it's the same park. And somebody mentioned that they did the same, they went from Android to iOS, and it's the same park. So because we've connected it to Facebook, and now this is essentially tied to that Facebook account, I'm pretty confident that when this game comes out on Android, which is meant to be early May, because a lot of you have been asking, early May this will be out on Android, I'm pretty confident that, oh, this thing we got in the pack. Little power generator. Just makes a little bit of money, really. I'm pretty confident that this account will carry on. So I'm a lot less apprehensive about buying packs and stuff like that every now and again, because I'm pretty damn sure this will continue and I won't have to worry about it randomly disappearing. Tapajara, you're going to go sit in the corner because you don't fit anywhere. You stay over there. So yeah, I really think it's going to continue, so I don't really have to worry about it anymore. Legendary packs, due to being ridiculously expensive, are still going to be a rarity. But once every couple of weeks or something like that, we'll get a legendary pack and see what cool stuff we get. Speaking of which, I do have a bit of cash on the account, and we're going to try a super rare pack today. I think I've got enough cash for it. Sorry about this. That email is a spam email. If people want to email it, they can, but I never go on it. I made it just so I can make an Australian account, so we wouldn't be achieving too much, must be honest. Right, super rare pack. Let's hope for something a little bit more impressive than last time. Good amount of food. That's okay. A super rare Metriorhynchus, okay. No! Go away. Again, that's still not something we're going to do all the time or anything. It's just I had a bit of cash left over, so I thought, why not? Metriorhynchus. Now, this will be, assumedly it's a super rare, will be even better than level 10. Yeah, 215 to 82. Those are insane stats, ladies and gentlemen. They are insane stats. So that will actually replace our poor, where's our new guy gone? Coolosuchus, who's awesome and everything. is brand new and is now suddenly in 10 hours he's pretty bloody useless, unfortunately. Oh well, okay. I'd like to expand the park more, but they're not allowing me. Anyways, we've got two new missions, so let's have a look. Excuse me, hi, I'm Owen Grady. Oh, what's my mic doing? Go away, Mike. Excuse me, hi, I'm Owen Grady. You might have seen me before. I worked down at the Raptor Paddocks. Oh no, not you. You're the guy I was supposed to meet. I'm not offended, if that's what you're wondering. Sorry, I didn't mean it that way. It's just blah, 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 blah. Someone who works here. Well, aren't you practically married? Of course it's someone who works here. You're meeting him on Jurassic World. Who else is going to be there? I'm sorry this isn't going to pan out. Senior management, office romances don't work well. It's 7:30 at night. Barry, in place of power generator. I didn't buy it. The game gave me one, but still. I will have your delicious, nutritious experience points. Thank you very much, Claire. What do you want, my friend? I did it already! Give me points! Which means we'll unlock level 12, which means Stegosaurus. For our next stop, I'm taking you on a special tour of our control room where your aunt works. Will we get to see Aunt Claire? Why, she doesn't seem too concerned, but he matured very early. Episode 6. Oh, there's a raptor. Ooh, there's a level up. Ooh, there's a Stegosaurus. Ooh, there's a mystery pack. Ooh, there's a lot of gold. Ooh, there's some points. Ooh, a paleontologist. Ooh, some food. Ooh. Ah. Oh, no, I should have waited. Can I afford that? I don't know if I can. Let's find out. No! That's really sad. I should have waited. Thinking about it, in retrospect, I should have waited. Place a newly hatched contour seems unlikely. Hmm. Oh, right, yeah, give me points. Thing is, Carnotaurus, I'm just about managing to level. He's sitting at level 20 now, and he's rare, so he's better than level 30 Majungasaurus. If we get a super, when we get the legendary Suchomimus, he's probably going to be better than a level 30 Carnotaurus, but he will be near impossible to ever level up, unless I buy another legendary pack, or unlock him later on in battle or something. Whatever, give me points, give me points, give me points. I have authorized Dr. Wu to enlist your help in selecting a dinosaur for our upcoming cloning project codenamed Ares. Before I begin experimenting, I'll need suitable test subjects to work with. Your choice, of course. Level up two different dinosaurs. Oh. I can't! All my dinosaurs are max level! I've been too efficient! I'm too efficient! Every single one of them is at level 10, 20, or 30. Every single bloody one of them. Look. That is ridiculous. Screw it. Right, what we're going to do. That's quite cheap, and I've got that. Do I have that? Yes. Okay, good. Right. I get hold of these iTunes point thingamajiggies a little bit cheaper, so it's not as expensive as it actually looks. Ladies and gentlemen, let's get some goddamn new creatures. We're going to start off with the Metriorhynchus, just because it's less exciting than the Suchomimus. Still pretty exciting, just less exciting. He's actually really cool. It's like a crocodile with the tail of a fish. Just stick them all up here for now, and we'll work out other stuff in a minute. Hello! You're terrifying. Very messy eater, aren't you? Yeah, those stats are insane. What's going on? That is crazy stats. 215 health, 82 attack. That's better than anything else in the park, and it's level 10. What is this Suchomimus going to be like? Because we're about to get it. We are about to unlock the Suchomimus. This thing is going to be crazy. Hi, hi. Come over here, please. Okay, that's kind of a pattern. It's not fantastic. And Tabiara kind of messes with it. I need room. I've got no room. Okay. We're gonna get it to level 10 and then check the stats. Oh, we can already see. Oh my god, the stats are crazy! No, I don't have that much. Must. God damn it! Okay, do I have enough? I don't know. It's low. Yes, we're okay. We're okay. Okay. This is insane! Got so much to level up! Ah! Suchomimus! What are you crazy? Hello? What you doing? Is that a new animation just for the Suchomimus? Wonder if the legendary creatures all have unique animations. Do a different one. There we go. Shaky, shaky. Oh god. 437 health, 112 attack. That is madness personified. Absolutely mad. Alacrest ACU guards. Okay, more missions. So many missions. Important on all our guests have a good time. Your guest, you're the owner. This is Miss Masrani. He's the owner. Collect from a building with a bonus of 4% or higher. I mean, that's pretty easy to do. All we have to do, grab this, move it over there. Grab this, move over there. And click. There we go. Lovely jubbly. How did you do it? Become a billionaire? I'm a self-made man, Zach. I see something I want, I go after it. I've never waited for anyone to hand me my fortune. Mr. Masrani, I want to be a self-made man too. Rich like you, I mean, will you teach me how? Will you teach me how to be rich? Okay. Have that. Yeah, just knocking them out of the park. I'm going to be level 13 in a second. That's crazy. It's crazy! I mean, this is what happens when you kind of chuck a bit of money at the game, but still, I get to show you guys some cool stuff. Oh. Oh, another Utah Raptor. Cool. No, I want it! I want it! Ah! No, what are you doing? No. Oh, it's so tempting. That is so disgustingly tempting. It's half price. And I've got the money. $31 on this is nowhere near $31 to me in pounds and stuff like that. And because of a few other things knocking about. And yesterday, I said, I don't want to do this anymore, but now I'm keeping the account, it matters less, and it's there, and it's half price, and I think, yes, if I just say yes. Okay, I'm gonna see if this is doable. I'm gonna sort some stuff out. We shall see. Okay, funny thing happened, I went and sorted it out, so I could actually do it, and when I came back onto Jurassic World, the offer had gone, so that's great. Yeah, that's helpful, fantastic. We'll just have to wait, I suppose. It's there, it's ready. It would be nice to space them out a little bit more. It's just because we're in the early kind of stages of the life of the game, you know, and I'm very excited to see everything at this point, and I don't mind chucking a bit of money at it to make some exciting things happen. It will definitely settle down as time goes past. Time for another matchup. Okay, so we've got... Oh, God. It's further run a tight ship. What's inside is a concern. Concerns all of us. Do you understand? Place a newly hatched carnivore. Are we working on anything? We're not actually working on anything right now. So... Did we get any prices for any of these? No. That's all for later. There's a lot of dinosaurs in this game. Anyways, if we hatch the Utah Raptor, that should... sort that mission out, and I think the others are basically battle. Yeah. Oh, no. Okay, battle arena it is. As you can see, I've actually managed one of these, the live arena, the first one. I did actually pull that off, but let's just go straight for the Stegosaurus, who doesn't stand. Although, wow, the Stegosaurus is pretty insane. It's a level 26 rare. Huh. This Stegosaurus is mad. okay. It's... Wow. It's so much better. Is it just as rare? It's a super rare. Oh, cool. Right, okay. No wonder it's amazing. If we just lead with the three carnivores, none of them are actually as good as the Stegosaurus, but I'd assume three carnivores, even whilst not being the same quality, will be able to handle one Stegosaurus. I'm assuming, not full of hope, must be said. I'm just gonna go full on attack. If he doesn't block, he dies. No, there we go. done. Well done, Suchomimus. I mean, that guy's not gonna be level 11 for a billion years. And now I'm annoyed that I just put the bloody Utah Raptor in. There we go. So Stegosaurus, our first super rare that we've gotten through kind of normal procedure. The first super rare we've gotten just by playing the game generally has officially been unlocked. Well, will be. I just have no room at all. This is the problem with this system. What we're going to do, knock some road out here. Oh, bit more there. You need to be replaced anyway. Our best dinosaur in terms of fanciness is definitely the Suchomimus. So Suchomimus is going to go sit. Oh, it's so not worked. Oh, that is heartbreaking. Suchomimus is going to go sit down there. The road system is definitely better. I'm just trying to piece it together a little bit. So if we get rid of these, stick Guanlong in there. No Pyroraptor, I should say. Oh, I should have tested out in that battle, my bad. Okay. It doesn't have to be all super fancy quite yet. We'll get to super fancy town at some point. We always do. Let's move you out of the way for a second. Both of these are amphibious, so if we can make that exactly symmetrical, and we can, that's not bad. The problem is, it's very hard to reorganize, like, completely just because there's no bloody room. We need a lot more space. That's not bad, though. It's close. It's not perfect, but it's close. You, however, my friend, are blimmin' useless right now. Actually, so are you. Maybe I just stop worrying about this symmetry for a second and we just put these guys down in vaguely interesting spots, I suppose. Which, is apparently nowhere. Okay, let's just get rid of that road there. Come on, bloody terrifying Tapajara. Come on. There you go. Splendid. Oh, these need moving as well. These need to go on my blimmin'. Oh, they can't go in. Okay, one can go there. Suchomimus must. What's the gold ratio on the Suchomimus? 1500 every 3 hours. That's pretty crazy compared to most of these dinosaurs. Right, okay. So, in this episode, we have seen the brand new, terrifying Tapajara. We have seen the brand new, pretty terrifying, Metriorhynchus. Hello. We have seen the brand new, kind of adorable, Coolosuchus. We have seen the brand new, feathery Pyroraptor. And we have seen our very first legendary dinosaur, the very cool Suchomimus. It has been a productive episode, I feel. On the way, we have Stegosaurus, our first super rare herbivore, who is insane at level 27, but mine's not going to be level 27 for a very long time. It's very hard to work out. I mean, I need more of these point things. We're doing okay. We're starting to rack them up. But the main way to get them, like, I can sell. I checked this before. How much does Majunga sells at level 30 for 220, but he's only a common. Carnotaurus sells for about 300 or something like that. And that's enough to get me a rare, but I want a Carnotaurus, if anything. You know, I'd like another Carnotaurus. So I think the best way is still, for a while, just buying packs, really. Oh, well. Onwards! Oh, crikey. Okay. No, but nah. Can we do that? We might win. Let's give it a go. Let's finish off with a battle, eh? Because you never bloody know. I'm not confident and we don't really have variety in the... Oh, we're going to get destroyed. Wow. Gonna get wrecked. Is level 40 max then? Maybe for now, what I should be doing is focusing on leveling up the commons level 40, because that's definitely doable, and we can do that with the DNA we have to hand, you know? So maybe I should get, like, another Triceratops and another few Tapes and stuff like that. Oh, no. Okay, that's okay, that's okay. We're gonna have to swap to the Triceratops, but that's okay. We can deal with this, we can deal with this. just going to play a bit defensive, because this thing is going to require some beating. Very cool looking, though. Very cool. How these people have such cooler dinosaurs than me? Again, just going to play defensive, build up for one big attack, I think. Oh, never mind, about to die. No, okay, see, now I've got 6 points. I like this as a tactic. Four defense. So even if he hits me with five, he's only getting one hit in, and I'm going to have 8 points next round. Easy defense. This is working well. Oh, no, it doesn't build up. Okay, I forgot about that. We're maintaining balance. It's going to be slow, but methodical and effective, hopefully. It's not going to be effective. We're about to die massively. That was not a good technique. I'm going to lose. Attack! Full on attack. Don't block. That might still be a kill. Good stuff. You're so pretty! The level advantage is just huge. It's just ginormous. He's got 40 levels on me total. That's essentially a whole of a creature for him. It's essentially a 3v2 fight, this. Or a 4v3, whatever you want to call it. Come on, Alanqua. You can do it. One, two. Block. I'm going to do this. I can beat 80 levels with my 20. Okay, so now what we're going to do is 1, 2, 3, 4, double block. And hope we don't die. And then next turn, BAM! Big hit, because we'll have lots of points. Actually, no, not big hit. Because otherwise we'll just get killed by his guy. It's going to take a while, this. But it might work. I do have a plan forming in my head. So what we want to do is, we're going to hit for two. We're going to block for two. No, we're not. We're going to hit for three, block for two, three, and save two. Doesn't matter if it doesn't kill him. I've got some blocks on, hopefully. Oh, no, we're going to die. Don't know why I thought this would work. The level advantage was clearly way too much for me to ever win this. Alright, buddy, calm down. I take no responsibility for that defeat. I'm just putting this out there. I had no chance whatsoever. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, next episode we are going to have... Depending on when I record it, we will at least have a Utah Raptor, and we'll be ready to do that mission, and we will also knock out the, whatchamacallit, where's he gone? The Hatzigopteryx, who is a common flyer thingamajiggy. I've decided I do want my guys to all level up as much as they can. I mean, at one stage it does just bring in extra gold for a start, but the goal in Dresspot Builder was always... To max out every dinosaur, and that's still going to be the idea. The difference is, the battle system is far more integrated with this game than it ever was in Dresspot Builder until towards the end. So, right from the start, you kind of get it into your head that you want to build around that system. You want to build the best competitors and not waste resources on commons or even rares. Now, like, it feels weird putting points into Carnotaurus when I've got a legendary Sukumaima, so it feels weird putting points into Triceratops when I have a super rare Stegosaurus on the way, who is going to be better. But I don't know, I think if we keep maxing out like this, it'll work. Okay. We're going to finish off in a bit of style. Let's buy a super rare pack. No, we won't. No. Decided against it. I'm not going to do that anymore. When I level up and they offer them for half price, we'll grab a few every now and again, I think. And maybe a legendary pack when I'm feeling special. Other than that, we're going to try to hold back a little bit. Because it's fun to see the new stuff, but at the other side, it bugs me a little bit. And I don't want to ruin all the dinosaurs we're going to see down the line, you know? So if I can just focus it on actually being capable of winning these fights, like, we can win this fight. What's good against Helicopterix? Herbivore. So actually, if we get our Stegosaurus to level 10 against the Helicopterix, which is only a common, I believe, that should actually be quite a favourable matchup for the Stegosaurus. And then we'd follow up with the Suchomimus, which is obviously better than his Stegosaurus. And then we follow up with our level 30 Trope, which is good against his Coolosuchus. And actually, I'd win that on stats on all three rounds. So, good stuff. Okay. So, no more packs, unless we level up. Just for a little bit. We'll see. I'm just going to kind of play it by ear. We'll see what happens. I know I'm talking about this a lot, but it's a big thing in my head, because I don't want to, like, turn you guys away, because, like, oh, he's just buying his way to the top, blah, 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 you know, kind of stuff like that, if you got any word of that. But it is exciting, and it's quite fun to open them and see what's inside and stuff, even if the results usually aren't fantastic, it is an interesting thing to see. Speaking of which, who did we get in that pack? Did I buy a pack? I thought I bought a pack. I didn't buy a pack. We've got a Utah Raptor in the way, which we got for leveling up. It'd be nice to level up our Utahraptor, actually, wherever the hell he is, the little guy. You've been here for blimmin' ages, you have, and at the next level, we've seen what you look like, and you go all pretty in yellow and red, and it's lovely. Right, so, I will wait until the Stegosaurus is ready, and then next episode, we'll get him up to level 10, and we'll go and we'll take on Helicopterix and see where the missions and the game takes us from there. Thank you very much for joining me, as per usual, ladies and gentlemen, I shall see you lovely people in the next episode. Cheers, much love, and as always. Bye-bye.